Hello guys, welcome to yet another video by Stock Market Rulers. Today we will be discussing what is Elliott wave and what all nomenclature is used, how can we identify these waves, and what are the names of these waves. So we'll discuss all of this in this video. So basically, Elliott wave theory is a technical analysis that tells us about the direction of market on a longer time frame. So if you have the knowledge of Elliott wave, you can make your view accordingly. You know on what is happening on a bigger time frame, and you know the direction of the market. If it's rather bullish or bearish, you can decide if you have the knowledge of Elliott wave. The waves actually help you in deciding the momentum of market, how strong, if it's bullish, how strong bullish it's going to be, or if it's bearish, how extreme bearish it can get. So apart from getting the levels and all that we get from normal technical analysis, Elliott wave also provides us with the same feature, but it's kind of predictive. But if you have the knowledge of both Elliott wave and the technical analysis that we do, believe me, you are going to succeed in this market. So now we'll discuss what is Elliott wave, what are the waves that we have. But before we begin with the actual video, I would request all of you to please like, share and subscribe to our channel so that we can make more informative content for you. And thank you already for watching this video. So the basic structure of a wave is this. This is one, then it comes down, two, then it goes up. Third wave is usually the largest wave, then it comes down, fourth, and then fifth. So this is how it goes, right? Don't like move it like this. So it comes down like this. Fifth is not the largest. 1 second, fifth is like this, right? It cannot be larger than third. No wave cannot be greater than third. So this is the basic of a wave structure. And then we have corrective waves after this. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is called impulse wave. And post that we have is corrective waves. So this is, after this starts the corrective wave. The first wave down is called A. Then it goes up to a certain point B. And then it comes down C. So this is how corrective waves work. This is basically, this is not how they exactly it should be, but so just to give you an example, I am also in a learning phase, but this is the structure of a steep kar dete hain aise. So this is the basic structure of a rally in bull markets, what we call, right? So this is how it goes. So what is happening now? If we see, I am saying we are in these waves also have sub waves. So if I am saying the first wave is going on, so in that also we'll also have one. So in this one we'll also have one, then two, then three, then four, then five. So this is how this first wave will go, and when it will come down for two, so there will be another correction wave this way. So A, B, and then C. So this is how the wave goes. And then in again also for three, if you would like to know, like one of this will go, two it will come down, three up, four down, and then finally five. So this is how a wave structure goes, correct? So now what we are facing is, I am saying you that we are in first of third wave. ठीक है, तो third जो है वो main चल रही है wave. तो उसको 1 day के time frame पे अगर मैं आपको Nifty पे दिखाऊँ क्या हो रहा है, CPR. So I am saying that we are in first of third wave. So यहाँ से 15,200 से it started. And then it went up. So this is how, like, it's still going on. It's not over yet. It's still going on. So it's not over yet. It's still going on. One second. So I'll use a trend line to show. So suppose this wave is going till 18,500 I am saying. Suppose it's very predictive. I am not sure, but the price action, I'll tell you how it's telling me that we are going till 18,500. Now we'll come to a time frame of say 2 hours. Let's say. So in 2 hours you will see the sub wave of the. So now we'll see sub wave of 1 of 3. So 3 means that two have been ended here. A correction wave which was coming, or maybe blame it on the Ukraine war and this inflation thing. We ended the wave 2. I'll show that also, but just now let's discuss the sub wave of 1st of 3. So it started from, so let's say it started from here. This was the first, this was 1 of 3. Cool. Then second it came down for a correction 2. Then we were going for a third wave which was this long, you'd see. And now we are in its corrective phase, which is going down till this 17,200, which is expected. Why it is expected? Because fourth wave, if you talk about the books, it's in like books, it cannot go beyond 38% of the third wave and then beyond. So how now I have marked, let's come to even a smaller time frame. Now I'll just squeeze the chart. So how I have marked this fourth wave, and how it's, I know that it's the 38% of the third wave. So I'll use Fibonacci levels from here, I'll put it here, and then I'll go till the top of the third wave. So if you could see, it started from here, and then once, so यहाँ से यहाँ तक almost जितनी भी ये third length थी इसकी, इसका 38% यहाँ कहीं बन रहा है, थोड़ा से it's approximate, but yeah, till 38% we are seeing the target. Yeah, so 38% का target यही 17,200 के आसपास का हमारा बन रहा है. So अब और छोटे एक बार टाइम फ्रेम पे आते हैं देखने के लिए, 30 मिनट्स पे आ जाते हैं. सो अब फोर्थ वेव अगर हमारी डाउन आ रही है, जो करेक्टिव है, जिसका आज हम पकड़ नहीं पाए आज, तो फोर्थ वेव को करेक्टिव होने के लिए इट शुड बी इन ABC फॉर्म. सो इट स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम हेयर, वी सॉ एन ए, देन इट वेंट अप बी, एंड देन इट शुड कम डाउन टिल हेयर सी. सो देन द फोर्थ वेव विल एंड, बट देर आर चांसेस दैट इट मे और मे नॉट कम टू this 38%. There are chances that it might just come to the level of A. When it comes to the level of A, when C comes to the level of A, it is called flat corrective wave. It just becomes flat because it does not go beyond A. But technically it should. But there are many a times when it just ends here, when the trend is strong, or there could be any reason. It's all predictive, but we know the direction. So when it went up, it had to went up, because after a pullback, maybe you can say it had to come. But what I, Nishant sir, and everybody thought was that I had questioned him that are you sure we are not in the B wave of this fourth thing, because fourth waves are tricky. They hit SL on both sides and they sometimes make different pattern apart from this simple ABC down. It's not always ABC down in this fourth wave, especially second comes ABC down, which is very simple to trade, but in fourth waves it's very difficult to trade. There are more patterns actually which it forms, like that day I was showing you this something like this, that the price came from here and then it went and it did this and it went up, something like this. This can also be seen in C waves. So they are very difficult to trade, especially in fourth wave. This is what I mean. But some of us what we did, what where we went wrong. Even I am learning, so I didn't had that confidence on me. So some of the people said that this is A, then it went up B, and it came down. So the C happened here, and it's all done because we have come more than 23%. So I was like, okay, maybe the B would have ended up here, but I was still not convinced that the fourth wave will end this easily. But it's okay. I got my learning today that it's better to wait for the price action. It's better to wait fifth wave also if you are not sure. So this is what my learning is. Fourth wave, I'll never trade fourth wave again for sure wherever it's going, because it takes SL on both sides. Now it's coming down. It will come down in this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pattern only of impulse. It will come 1 till here, then 1 till here, then 2, it will go up slightly, then 3 will come down, then 4th will go up, and then 5th will somewhere come down. So 4th will go up, 5th will come to the Fibonacci level like this. So this is how the C wave will go. Like A also has these 1 2 3 4 5, and then C also has 1 2 3 4 5 down. So first we have 1 2 3 4 5 up, and second and fourth have ABC corrections in them, and then A down has again 1 2 3 4 5 downwards wave, and then B goes up in the impulse pattern again, and then down is also traced like this. So I hope I have cleared the basic structure to you. You would now know what 1 2 3 4 5 are in this current scenario, and so currently just make sure of this, that we are A ended here. I'll just delete it. So this is the structure the market is following. The A started here, B, and then C can come to this point. 38% retracement jo we can expect. So this is the basic structure that we are looking at. There are sub waves of this also, because it's still on a bigger time frame. Yesterday only I told someone that Elliott wave can be tracked on 1 minute time frame as well. So there are sub waves to everything. So but we cannot count it all on like every time frame. So we prefer 5 minutes and 1 hour mostly for our trading thing. So this is how it works. I hope you'll understand, and if you have any doubt, you can definitely ask me, you can question me, because I am also learning this. I'll be happy if you guys also learn with me. Thank you.